honorary civic and distinguished guests, councillors, ladies and gentlemen, and children, please be standing for the Mayor of Hartlepool. Please be seated and silent for the Managing Director, Denise McGuffin.
Welcome everybody to the Investiture Ceremony for the Ceremonial Mayor of Hartlepool. I would like to invite councillors to come forward and speak in support of the Mayor. The following councillors have been asked to come forward: Councillor Shane Moore, followed by Councillor Mike.
Lord Lieutenant, Mr. Mayor, honorary and civic guests, elected members, ladies, gentlemen and children, welcome to Hartlepool this evening. I have the honour of nominating Councillor Brian Cowie to take on the role as Ceremonial Mayor of Hartlepool this year. Now, Brian is a ward colleague of mine in the Headland and Harbour ward, and we first met last year following his election to the ward. And although I think even Brian will admit it was a little bit of a surprise in the election, he took to it on the first day and he's never stopped working since. I know how difficult it can be and how daunting it can be when you are a member of a political party who isn't necessarily part of the same makeup of that ward. I found myself in that position when I was first elected. But I think Brian's fitted in very well with the rest of us in the ward, and he's worked tirelessly with us and put politics aside. And that's been an absolute pleasure to see. But what I really love about Brian is that he's really passionate about the people of the ward. He fights day in and day out, and he hates to see injustice, and he really does battle on as best as he can to make sure that people's voices are heard. Outside of the council, Brian has led a successful life and has run a number of successful businesses. Brian has a much better sense of rhythm than I do and attends dances regularly in the Townsborough Hall on a Wednesday. And he's regularly trying to encourage more people to take dancing if anybody is that way inclined. Unfortunately, Brian, I won't be joining you in the dancing. But on that note, and because of that love for dance and Brian's charitable nature, he's also assisted more recently in arranging a special charity dance for to raise money for victims of the Ukraine crisis, which is coming very shortly, I believe, Brian.
Having been elected to the office of Ceremonial Mayor.
Having been elected to the office of Ceremonial Mayor.
Declare that I take the office upon myself.
Declare that I take that office on myself.
And will duly and faithfully.
And will duly and faithfully.
Fulfill the duties of it.
Fulfill the duties of it.
According to the best of my judgment and ability.
According to the best of my judgment and ability.
Now, Mayor of Hartlepool for the municipal year 22-23, Councillor Brian Cowie.
Lord Lieutenant, three men and three women, aldermen and alderwomen, honoured guests, councillors, family and friends. I am humbled and honoured to be chosen and elected to become the Mayor of Hartlepool. I also feel honoured that this challenge has fallen in the same year as Her Majesty the Queen Elizabeth celebrates her Platinum Jubilee year, and I look forward to all the celebrations ahead. I would like to thank my fellow councillors and officers for having the faith and belief in my abilities to serve in this esteemed role. From day one, I have adopted an open door policy that means everyone, councillors and officers alike, and welcome to share their ideas at any time. As our country begins to recover from the effects of the 2-year pandemic, I feel that it is important that we all strive together to repair the damage that this pandemic has caused. My vision is that this chamber be used to concentrate on the strategic work of council, that all parties be united and dedicated to improving the lives of the good people of Hartlepool in all ways possible. During recent times, it is my belief that antisocial behaviour has increased in Hartlepool. Therefore, our top priority for this council will be to focus on the future of our town and young people. And education, I believe, are the key to addressing the above problems. Young people are our future, and I will continue to support schools in every way I can to drive up standards and ensure children get the best start in life. I want to help promote civic life and offer an open invitation to all schools, and I will visit each and every one if so wish. I am extremely positive about the future, and everyone will agree that the local community will always be at the heart of everything that we do. I'm really looking forward to the next year as things unfold in Hartlepool, and I will continue to work with all councillors to achieve the very best for our town and the people of our town, and make sure it is a place where people are proud to live, work and play. Finally, just to add, I feel that the challenge ahead is a huge honour. And if I can do half as well as my predecessor, Brenda Loynes, I will be delighted. My charities are, for this year, with the Palace House Hospice, and Miles for Men, and Walk Forward. Thank you all very much indeed for being here tonight. May your God bless you all.
I would like to invite councillors to come forward and speak in support of the Deputy Mayor, Councillor Dennis Loynes. Can I invite Councillor Michael?
Lord Lieutenant, Mr. Mayor, honorary city guests, elected members, ladies and gentlemen, again, it's a great honour to nominate Councillor Dennis Loynes to the post of Deputy Mayor. The past year has not been the easiest for you, Councillor, and I'm trying to keep myself together on this, but I'm sure that Brenda is incredibly proud.
Again, I have the pleasure of seconding Councillor Dennis Loynes for the position of Deputy Ceremonial Mayor for Hartlepool for this next municipal year. Den and I have known each other for many years, and in fact, it was just by having a conversation the other night, we were quite shocked that it had been as long as it has when we realised that, that my son had recently turned 14. He's also been a stalwart politically in the town for many years before he became elected too. And I'm really pleased to see that you did end up getting a seat in the last year's election, and I hope you continue on that.
Deputy Mayor, Councillor Loynes, to sign the declaration of Deputy Mayor along with myself.
Good luck. Councillor Dennis Lawrence, who will spend his consort and husband to make a presentation of monies raised during municipal year of 2021-22, which totaled £7,125.52. To Alice House Hostess, £3,562.76. Miles for Men, War for Women, £3,562.76. Can I ask the representative from Alice House to come get the cheque from Dennis, Councillor Benson?
I'd just like to say a few words. Brenda always showed warmth and kindness to the hospice. Through her illness, she still worked tirelessly to raise this money, which is a fantastic amount, and it will go to provide our patients, support to our patients and their families. It's been a very difficult year for us all, but this means so much to us all, and I would just like to thank Dennis.
Charity rely on the support of things like this and the community raising funds for us. Brenda Loynes was an amazing person. You've got a big set of shoes to fill, Mr. Cowie. Well, thank you for choosing us as well as the chosen charity. When you're seeing Brenda's funeral, you're seeing the white horse and carriages that were provided by Mace for Men. The people's charity, as we say, but she'll be sadly missed. She wasn't only just a friend, she was a friend of mine. Partner's family for many, many years. So thank you, Brenda. Thank you, Dennis.
I would like to pay tribute to the work of the retired Deputy Mayor, Councillor Robert Cook, and request that this council records with gratitude the services rendered to the borough by the retiring Deputy Mayor, Councillor Robert Cook, and the manner in which he has discharged the responsible duties devolved on him.
Can I invite the retired Deputy Mayor, Councillor Rob Cook, to give thanks for his time and efforts, if you want to say a few words?
Can I just point out I was too late 5 seconds from Paris?
It wasn't a lot, was it?
As you all know, I never take any votes anyway. Can I just say, Lord Lieutenant, freemen and free women of Hartlepool, honorary aldermen and aldermen women, civic and distinguished guests, councillors, ladies and gentlemen, and of course, children. The last few months have proven to be an eventful time for the Deputy Mayor, as brother and myself. I took on the role of Deputy Mayor for the 2021-22, knowing fully what to expect as I had been Mayor of this great town of ours in 2016 and 2017, and Deputy in 2017-18. I did things by side first. However, seeing that the sad death of our beloved Mayor, Councillor Brenda Lawrence, in February changed things totally for us both, I decided to remain as Brenda's Deputy and fulfil the duties that she and Dennis would have continued to swell them. Brenda and I did quite a number of events and can say that we were welcomed by all of the chamber. We attended events all over the area and met up with old friends and made some new ones. To represent Hartlepool in any way at all is an honour, and not a lot of people get the chance to do that. We were given that chance 3 times and we took it. There are too many people to mention individually that helped to make this happen, so thanks to you all. However, saying that, Brenda and I would like to personally thank Geoff Richardson, our Mace bearer, chauffeur, and most of all, a very good friend, for being there for us and keeping us in line. from someone mentioned a couple of times that he got us lost, but sorry, I didn't say that. Finally, I want to wish our new Mayor, Councillor Brian Cowie, and his deputy Mayor, Councillor Dennis Loynes, all the best for their year in office. I know that if you enjoyed as much as I did, you will have a blast. Thank you, may God bless you all.
Commended, because not only have you kept all your essential services going, you've dealt with everything that was thrown at you in the pandemic, but you've also looked forward and you've been planning for all the exciting things that are going to happen in Hartlepool in the future, and you have to be congratulated. Everybody, the team, all the staff here, to be congratulated for the way that they dealt with that. Brenda Loynes was a very, very special person. It wasn't just a privilege and a pleasure to have the opportunity to get to know the two of you. It was an absolute joy. She wasn't just an inspiration, she was a role model. And her family were so important to her, but so was this borough. And with Brenda, the most impressive thing for me was the fact that it wasn't about the politics, it was about the people. And that's what I'd like you all to remember. We've come through the most horrible, horrible time. Let's look forward and see what we can do by working together. I was here last week, I've been actually in Hartlepool, sneaked in twice recently to English Martyrs. They very kindly asked me to open the new sixth form centre and library, and then I went back last week to join them in celebrating the Platinum Jubilee. And believe me, we had fun. It was the most amazing experience. I didn't have the ice cream, but it was only 20 to 10 in the morning. But they were all enjoying their ice cream and wonderful games. We had a fabulous assembly. And then it was representing the Commonwealth as well. So there were all sorts of things like limbo dancing. And there was a long, long queue. Brenda would have joined me in this. Long, long queue for the limbo dancing. And I think they were thinking, she's not going to do it. She's not going to do it. So I just walked up to the two young people and said, lift the bar and walk them. So that was my contribution to the day. But these young people that you have here, they are our future. And you're all part of that. I have the privilege of representing Her Majesty the Queen here, another inspirational lady. And you know, when you think about it, 70 years and what she's done, she's seen everything, been through every turmoil you can think of. And she's been constant. She's been our constant throughout. And aren't we so very privileged as we were with Brenda? And her legacy's here. Her legacy's here. She was wonderful. Mind he didn't do such a job when we had the Burns night. He was in trouble. He was in trouble trying to get Brenda around. Am I not correct? And you were reprimanded a number of times, I spotted. But a wonderful, wonderful lady, and long may you work together and in the way that she would want you to. Thank you. Thank you all for attending and showing your support to Hartlepool.
Honorary, sorry, distinguished guests, councillors, ladies and gentlemen, and children, please be standing until the mayor of Hartlepool has left the chamber.
Well done.